Students, today we will discuss Bose-Einstein distribution law. I am Dr. S.V. Kolle, Department of Physics, Shivaji College, Kannada District, Aurangabad. See, friends, Bose used Planck's hypothesis according to which radiation in temperature enclosure are composed of light quantas called photons. And the photons have energy E is equal to h nu. And these photons in the enclosure are indistinguishable. Now, we will see basic postulates of this B statistics. First, particles of the system are identical and indistinguishable. Means we can't differentiate them. They are identical and indistinguishable. Second, any number of particles can occupy a single cell in phase space. You know what is phase space? It is combination of momentum space and position space. And third, size of the cell cannot be less than h cube. H is Planck's constant. So number of phase cells is comparable with number of particles. So fifth, B statistics is applicable to particles with integral spin angular momentum in units of h upon 2 pi. So students, now consider a system of n independent and indistinguishable particles having definite energy and occupy definite positions. Now we have n particles. So to determine their energy distribution in equilibrium state, we have to divide this available volume in phase space into large number of compartments, key compartments. Then again we divide each compartment to elementary cells. See here, this is volume in phase space. It is divided first into number of compartments, 1, 2, k minus 1. And again, this compartment divided into number of elementary cells. These are elementary cells, see here. And size of this cell is h cube. Now, friends, let n1, n2, n1, nk particles having energy values, capital E1, capital E2, capital EI, capital EK respectively. And they are in compartments 1 to k, we have seen already, and containing the compartments containing G1, G2, GI, GK cells respectively in them. So, total number of particles of the system, n is equal to n1 plus n2 plus n3 plus ni plus nk. Now, total number of possible ways of arranging these ni particles with gi minus 1 partitions is equal to ni plus gi minus 1 factorial. Friend C, if there are two cells, there is single partition, you know. So if there are GI cells, then there are GI minus 1 partitions. Now, actual number of ways in which NI particles are to be distributed in GI cells in ith compartment, it is WI is equal to NI plus GI minus 1 factorial upon NI factorial into GI minus 1 factorial. The equation first. Now, total number of different arrangements for all N particles of the system. It is given by W N1, comma N2, NI, NK is equal to N1 plus G1 minus 1 factorial upon N1 factorial into G1 minus 1 factorial into N2 plus G2 minus 1 factorial upon N2 factorial into G2 minus 1 factorial into NI plus GI minus 1 factorial upon NI factorial into GI minus 1 factorial into NK plus GK minus 1 factorial upon NK factorial into GK minus 1 factorial. Now, it is equal to product sin I is equal to 1 to K, NI plus GI minus 1 factorial upon NI factorial into GI minus 1 factorial. Equation second. This is product sin. Means here is product of all terms. So, we can write this in product sin. Now, most probable macro state W is equal to WN1, N2, NI, NK is equal to product of NI plus GI factorial upon NI factorial into GI factorial. Here we have neglected one. See here, this one is neglected because NI plus NI and GI are large numbers. And so we have neglected one. Now taking natural logarithm of on both sides of this equation three. So log W is equal to summation I is 1 to K in bracket log. Now here use log A upon B. So log A minus log B. So log, this ni plus gi factorial minus this log ni minus log gi. Now, using Stirling approximation, log n factorial is equal to n log n minus n. So, using this Stirling approximation here, log w is equal to summation I is 1 to k in bracket ni plus gi log ni plus gi minus ni plus gi minus ni log ni plus ni minus gi log gi plus gi bracket complete. So is equal to summation I is 1 to k in bracket ni plus gi log ni plus gi minus ni log ni minus gi log gi. Now friends, see, we have to obtain set of maximum thermodynamic probability. So we have to differentiate this equation 4 and then equate it to 0. So del log w is equal to 0. This is the condition. So differentiate this equation. So del log w is equal to summation I is 1 to k in bracket. Now take this term here, a product of a and b. So keep first term constant, then differential of second, again keep second term constant, differential of first term, like this. So log ni plus gi is taken constant and differential of this is del ni, and plus ni plus gi is kept constant and differential of log ni plus gi is 1 upon ni plus gi into del ni. Again minus log ni is kept constant, differential of ni is del ni, minus ni is kept constant, differential of this is 1 upon ni del ni, and this is constant, so it differential is 0. So simplifying this, we can write summation of I is 1 to k del ni log ni plus gi minus del ni log ni, because here this will get cancelled, so del ni, and again minus this del ni, because we can also cancel this, so it is 0. So finally we can write this step. So del log w is equal to summation I is 1 to k in bracket log of ni plus gi upon ni outside del ni. So minus summation I is 1 to k. Now invert this. So log of ni upon ni plus gi into del ni is equal to 0. So summation I is 1 to k log of ni plus gi upon ni into del ni is equal to 0. Equation 5. Now friends, see, our system must satisfy two auxiliary conditions. First is conservation of proton number of particles. Means n is summation I ni is constant, number of particles constant. So differential of this del n is equal to 0. So del n is equal to summation I delta ni is equal to 0. Equation 6. And second is conservation of total energy of the system. Means E, total energy of the system is equal to summation I ni Ei is constant. This energy is constant. So differential of this is del E is equal to summation I Ei dni is equal to 0. Equation 7. Now students, we shall apply Lagrangian method of undetermined multipliers. For this, we have to multiply equation 6 by alpha and equation 7 by beta and add these two equations in 5. See here, we have to multiply this equation by alpha and multiply this equation by beta, and we have to add these two equations in this equation. So doing this, we can write summation I 1 to k is equal to in bracket log of ni upon ni plus gi plus alpha plus beta ei outside delta ni is equal to 0. Equation 8. Now log ni upon ni plus gi plus alpha plus beta ei is equal to 0. So log of ni upon ni plus gi is equal to minus alpha minus beta ei, because here we have inverted this term. So ni upon this, we have taken this, not inverting, because we have taken this term on right side, so minus sign. So log of ni upon ni plus gi is equal to minus alpha minus beta ei. So ni upon ni plus gi, now we have removed this log sign here, So ni upon ni plus gi is equal to e raised to this term minus alpha minus beta e is equal to e raised to minus sine outside to bracket alpha plus beta e. So ni plus gi upon ni. Now we have inverted this. So is equal to e raised to plus alpha plus beta e. So this one plus gi upon ni is equal to e raised to alpha plus beta e. So gi upon ni is equal to e raised to alpha plus beta e minus this one. So ni is equal to e raised to this gi upon this e raised to alpha plus beta e minus one. Equation 9. This equation 9 is Bose-Einstein distribution law for assembly of bosons. Now use beta is equal to 1 upon kT in equation 9. Here in equation 9 use beta is equal to 1 upon kT. So we can write ni is equal to gi upon e raised to alpha into e raised to beta e I minus 1. So is equal to gi upon e raised to alpha here e raised to e I upon kT minus 1, equation 10. Now friends, B distribution is a distribution function. Here FEI is equal to ni upon gi, number of states upon number of particles per quantum state. So from equation 10, FEI is equal to 1 upon e raised to alpha e raised to ei upon kT minus 1. Equation 11, for continuous distribution of energy, we can write FA is equal to 1 upon e raised to alpha e raised to e upon kT minus 1, equation 12. Now, friends, Bose-Einstein energy distribution law for continuous variation of energy. Now, when the energy levels of the system are closely packed, they form a quasi-continuous spectrum. In these, if GD is number of energy states between the energy range E and E plus D, we can write GI is equal to GED. And if NED is number of particles whose energy lies between this energy range E and E plus D, then we can write NI is equal to NED. From equation 10, we get, see this equation 10, from this equation we can write NED is equal to GED upon E raised to alpha into E raised to E upon kT minus 1, 13 equation. Now, for the system consisting of free particles with no spin, GED is given by GED. This GED is equal to 2 pi V into 2m upon h square raised to 3 by 2 e raised to half d, equation 14. Now, friends, substitute this value in equation 13. So, NED is equal to this GED value, put here GED value. So, NED is equal to 2 pi V into 2m upon h plus h square raised to 3 by 2 into e raised to half d upon e raised to alpha into e raised to e upon kT minus 1 for 15 equation. Now this 15 equation is Bose-Einstein energy distribution law for continuous distribution of energy among free particles with no spin. Reference I used for this PowerPoint presentation preparation. Thank you.